In a marathon planning meeting yesterday afternoon, councillors gave the go-ahead to a massive redevelopment on the site of the old Amex House building on Edward Street. Latest TV sent new reporter Ted Jeffrey to Hove Town Hall to find out more.
A huge £100 million office complex is to be built in the centre of the city. Yesterday afternoon, Brighton and Hove City Council Planning Committee approved the redevelopment of the site of the former American Express wedding cake office on Edward Street. The buildings, which will be between 3 and 8 stories high, will accommodate 2,000 office staff, and there will also be 168 new homes, a GP surgery, and a community space to be rented out to local groups. Latest TV was at Hove Town Hall yesterday, where a spokesman for the developer said the project will bring more jobs to the area.
First of all, I'd just like to respond to comments made in the press recently about our consultation approach. We have undertaken a comprehensive engagement process with local residents and stakeholders, including 4 consultation events, 3 drop-in sessions, 6,000 newsletters distributed, door knocking and newspaper articles. Any suggestion that we have not consulted is simply not true.
The plan is not without its opponents, though. Derek Peacock told the meeting, "The development we have before us today is not the right scheme, and we ask that you will reject it."
There's been an overwhelming response to this planning application by the local community. We are pro-development and pro-city plan, but the application you have before you today is not the right scheme, and we ask that it should be rejected. We passionately want a development that reflects the creativity and future thinking of the city of Brighton and Hove, that enhances the lives of residents and that all can share.
It took 3 hours for the councillors to come to a conclusion, and they had some tough questions for the first base team before giving their consent.
I still have a problem with the traffic because I know how the traffic is, especially then Sundays as well, and you have boy races there because you have other blocks of flats there as well, and they all have the traffic. I know how difficult the parking there is.
In respect to parking, you're correct. There are 56 spaces proposed within the basement car park. The total allocation on our maximum standards would be in the order of about 765 to 170 spaces. We consider the level of parking proposed here to be acceptable given the accessibility of the site in relation to the station, bus routes and other matters. In terms of the potential for overspill parking, you'll note that we're in a controlled parking zone, and that in condition 20 of this application, we will be removing the eligibility of residents to apply for parking permits.
The decision passed 8-4. This morning, First Base said the project would bring modern workspace into the city, keep businesses and jobs local, and provide much-needed homes.
Ted Jeffrey there reporting from Hove Town Hall. Today we were joined in the studio by Derek Peacock, who we just saw making his objections known at yesterday's meeting. Derek Peacock joins me now, a resident of White Street. Obviously you're disappointed with the decision on the development. Can you tell me why, on behalf of yourself, and how long have you been a resident of White Street, first of all?
I've been in White Street for 43 years, and it's a very close community. From the 2013 draft planning brief, we expected a much lower development and it down in scale, and like the small terraced houses which we live in. And we've been disappointed with the development, obviously, because First Base have put in a much larger scale development than we expected in the 2013 draft.
Okay, so in layman's terms, how would that affect you as a resident of White Street?
It affects
once
me,
that development goes up?
The scale of Block D is absolutely enormous. It starts at 8 stories, comes down to 6 behind my garden wall, goes right down to the bottom of Edward Street. It will affect the light in my house. I will lose the sunlight in my garden, and it will affect everybody greatly.
And Roger Aramina, Brighton Hove Heritage Commissioner, told us on balance he's in favour. I understand you're in agreement with that.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Nothing is ever going to be perfect. This is a huge development. Under the council guidance, the planning brief, it had to be mixed use with a heavy emphasis on office and residential.
OK. Obviously, the local residents aren't happy. Are their objections valid, do you think?
You're never going to get a perfect world in such a large development. White Street in particular, being the closest part to the development, do have issues. one of which was light. But in fact, I think on balance, the developers have erred in favour of those properties, particularly down the south end, in order to make sure that the rears of the gardens, rears of the properties and the gardens actually do have sufficient light.